Hi, it's Katrina.
Number 10. Lombardy Castle. Castello di Lombardia was built in Sicily back in the 1st millennium BCE. It wasn't built by the Romans or the Italians, but by a unique group of people known as the Sicani. Over 2,000 years ago, there were three main groups living in Sicily. This was at the same time that the Phoenicians and Greeks were colonizing much of the Mediterranean. There were the Sicani in the middle, the Elymians to the west, and the Siculus to the east. The Sicani were arguably the greatest builders of the three. They constructed Lombardy Castle to be a megalithic fortress which could protect their royalty from any kind of attack. They built the foundations of the fortress on a hill nearly 3,000 feet above sea level. It remained such a defensive stronghold against invasion that no one could conquer it. That is, until the Romans figured out how to slither through the sewer network. And to this very day, it remains standing strong. It was occupied by the Roman Empire, later by the Byzantines, and was such a rock of a castle that it resisted Arab assault over 1,000 years after it was built. But eventually the Arabs did conquer Sicily and they took over the castle. Following their victory, they rebuilt the fortress and turned it into an even stronger fort in the 10th century AD. The castle was later occupied by the Normans, and in the 13th century had even more improvements made, with 20 extra towers added by Frederick II, King of Sicily. These days, the most surprising part of the castle is actually underneath. There is an ancient Sicon temple hidden within the tower and walls. The temple was built over 2,000 years ago by a group of Sicon cult members in worship of Ceres, goddess of fertility, crops, and motherly relationships. Ceres was once one of the most popular goddesses in all of Italy, worshipped by cults across the entire country. Number 9. The Horn Fortress. Wakra Bukhara is also known as the Horn Fortress, and for good reason. It's located in the district of Pomakanchi in Peru, and was occupied by the ancient Kanchi ethnic group. Just like Machu Picchu, this old fortress was built at the top of the highest peak in the region, at the very precipice of a stony cliff with two massive rock formations that from a distance look like devil horns. The history of this place is nothing short of amazing. According to local legends, the Kanchi were an ancient race of people who had been living in Peru for centuries. But when the Inca rose to power and began conquering, the Kanchi were left off guard and outmatched. They fought a brutal war with the Inca on the slopes of Mount Pinaipampa, but were ultimately defeated. The surviving Kanchi then fled to the Horn Fortress, a place they knew was nearly impossible to conquer. They locked themselves up in the fort at the top of the mountain, and the Inca laid siege for 15 days. The Kanchi were finally forced to surrender, lest they starve to death. In the end, the Kanchi swore their loyalty to the Inca. They were spared from execution, although 100 of their bravest warriors had to have one of their ears cut off to mark them as troublemakers. Following the subjugation of the Kanchi, the Inca took over the Horn Fortress. It became a secure residence for the Inca nobility and a center for astronomical observation. Number 8. The Belogradchik Fortress. The Belogradchik Fortress is like something out of a video game. It's an ancient fortress constructed inside a natural geological formation in the Balkan Mountains, deep in the countryside of Bulgaria. The Romans built this gigantic rock castle in the 3rd century, and it honestly looks like a castle inside the mouth of a volcano. The natural formation is like a mountain of stone, with tall fingers of red rock towering up to the clouds like skyscrapers. The Romans used their ingenuity to construct rooms, pathways, and towers inside of the formation, giving them unparalleled views of the surrounding region. The initial motivation behind the fortress was to protect the gold and other goods that were being transported from the lands of Thrace. After the fall of Rome, it continued to be used by the Byzantines for surveillance. Emperor Justinian I improved the fortress in the 6th century. Then the Slavic people invaded the Balkan Peninsula, the fortress was destroyed, and it remained an abandoned ruin until a period of reconstruction in the Middle Ages. It wasn't used again until the Bulgarian Tsar of Vidin, Ivan Stratsimir, saw its potential and rebuilt the entire thing. Shortly after, he was captured by the Ottomans and executed by strangulation. Number 7. Horbashin. Horbashin is an extremely mysterious island fortress located in Siberia. There have been plenty of excavations done here, and yet no one can determine, beyond any doubt, who built this bizarre place. Most evidence suggests it was a Yughir palace in the 8th century AD, but the history prior to that is extremely vague. We're also not entirely sure when the island was abandoned. Historians have guessed it happened shortly after the 8th century, after the Uyghur left and the island was converted into a monastery. Archaeologists have found evidence of earthquake damage, as well as fire damage. There was without a doubt some kind of catastrophe here, but it's all quite strange, and no one has any definitive answers. Let's look at where the fortification actually is. The entire island is covered in walls. It was basically a floating stronghold, as if they had built a castle on the back of a giant turtle. The island is inside Lake Terekol, which itself is over 4,000 feet above sea level. It's in southern Siberia, high up in the Sengalen Mountains, close to the border of Mongolia. In ancient times, the only way to reach the fortress island would have been by traveling thousands of miles across the desolate wastelands of Siberia, then using a boat to cross the lake after bringing your entire party 4,000 feet up a mountain. It really was isolated, which adds to its mystery. It wasn't even excavated until the end of the 1950s. And now for number 6, but first, it's shoutout time! I want to give a big shoutout to BC and Grace Makowski III. Thanks so much for watching and supporting this channel. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already to join the Origins Explained family. Number 6. Aleppo. Aleppo is an ancient city hidden within the heart of a modern city. These days, Aleppo is more commonly associated with the conflict in Syria than the ancient world. But within the modern city is an old quarter of ancient walls, narrow alleys, and relics from the Bronze Age all the way to the Middle Ages. Unfortunately, many of the older pieces of architecture were ruined in the Battle of Aleppo that happened in 2012. And even more historic buildings were either burned deliberately or smashed to pieces in 2014. But there is one thing that still stands strong in the ancient city, and that is the Citadel of Aleppo. It's located on a hill in the center of the city, and historians agree it's one of the biggest and oldest fortresses anywhere on the planet. It's been continuously occupied for over 3,000 years, conquered by the Persians and the Greeks, the Romans, the Byzantines, the Turks, the Arabs, and even the Mamluks. The present version of the fortress was constructed by the Ayyubid dynasty, following the great ruler Saladin, who recaptured Jerusalem from the Crusaders in the Third Crusade. By the time the Ottomans came into the region, the fortress was used primarily as a barracks. But this ancient fortress still had use in recent years. The French occupied it in World War I, and during the Syrian Civil War, it once more served its purpose as a powerful military stronghold. Number 5. Old Oswestry Hill Fort. It was during the Iron Age, around the year 1000 BC, that Old Oswestry was built in Britain. It was a monumental hill fort at a time when the region was occupied by what were considered tribal savages. The island of Great Britain was divided into different tribal territories, and each one of these territories was defended by primitive strongholds. They built their strongholds on top of hills, which is why we call them hill forts today. It gave them a great vantage over the territory, seeing as how flat England can be. Even a small hill gave a tremendous advantage. The Oswestry Hill Fort was one of the greatest. It was part of a dense wall of hill forts spanning the border of eastern Wales. But Oswestry was one of the biggest. It also remained in continuous use for a shocking 1,000 years. Excavations were done in 1939 by William Varley, but nobody really took any interest until the 1990s. William learned that the fortress had been completed during four distinct phases. First came some inner ramparts in the earliest part of the Iron Age. Then, in the Middle Iron Age, the fort was reorganized and enlarged, most likely in anticipation of an attack. Hundreds of years later came a giant overhaul with a total reconstruction. Each phase saw the fort grow larger and larger, and it remained in use up until the year 43 AD. That was the year the Romans showed up in Britain and started rampaging across the lands. Number 4. Carnan. Karnen is the main historical feature of the small Danish city of Helsingborg. It's all that remains of a former fortress tower, currently situated in the peaceful Slottshagen City Park above the Old Town. The top of the tower gives a splendid view over the entire city and the surrounding area, but its view 700 years ago would have been significantly different. Even though the tower still stands, it's very old. Karnen was built in the 14th century as a Danish fortress and occasional residence of Danish kings. The walls were thick, surrounded by even thicker defensive walls. The royal apartments were situated at the very top of the tower and could only be reached by a drawbridge connected from the defensive wall to the third floor of the tower. It was like an island inside a castle. There was a huge courtyard surrounding the central tower, and layer after layer of defensive walls and archer towers to defend against invasion. There was even a huge moat that was dug out to be 45 feet deep. As you can probably imagine, this felt like a really safe place to hide. The only way in was to swim across a moat while under constant attack by the archers in the towers, then breach a series of nearly impenetrable walls. Sadly, the fortress was mostly torn apart by the Swedish king, Karl XI, in 1681. The only thing he left standing was the central tower, which survives to this day. Number 3. Järnberg Castle. Järnberg Castle is in the middle of absolutely nowhere. It's about 2 miles from Steeple Langford village in the United Kingdom, in such a rural part of England that there isn't even any public access to this ancient historical site. These days, the castle has been reduced to dirt. There is nothing here except vague hints of the past in the forms of earth mounds. But long ago, it was a gigantic fortification that played a critical role in ancient England. Its outer ramparts would have stood over 11 feet high, with deep ditches that could swallow a man whole. There were tall ramparts, inner and central defensive positions, and a core enclosure in the center. The main portion of the castle was built starting around the year 100 BC. Pottery discovered here can be traced all the way into the Iron Age with the invasion of Rome into Britain. What this means is that the castle was almost certainly inhabited by the native British before the Romans ever showed up. There are over 130 remains of structures of various sizes in the area, suggesting a large settlement had flourished here with Järnberg Castle as the main fortification. Then it was conquered by the more powerful Roman military. The Romans commandeered the castle, as is evident by the sheer number of Roman artifacts uncovered during excavations. Everything from coins to Roman skeletons. Then, over the years, the castle was abandoned, and it just kind of fell out of use. Number 2. Ayaz Kala. Ayaz Kala is an old, dusty fortress in the Kizil Qum Desert of Uzbekistan. Historians believe the fortress most likely came into existence in the 2nd century AD. Likely built by the Kushan Empire. It may have been part of a series of fortifications that crossed all the way from the eastern part of the desert to the western part. This would have been a kind of border wall to protect the dwellers of the oasis beyond. Each fortification would have been in sight of the other, so that they could send signals if an enemy decided to attack. There are other fortresses in the region, but Ayaz Kala is arguably the most interesting. Unlike many of the other fortresses of ancient Uzbekistan, it seemed to also contain rural establishments. There were residential buildings discovered inside the ruins of the fortress, each one equipped with a yard enclosed by a short brick wall. These yards would have been planted with gardens and orchards, and each house was large enough to contain an entire family. Ayaz Kala wasn't exactly a settlement or a city, but a fortress complex which accommodated border detachments 1,900 years ago. It just so happened that a couple of families had moved into the place, maybe the families of the commanders, and they brought lush gardens to the desert. Number 1. Colossi. Colossi Castle is one of the most impressive examples of medieval architecture in the country of Cyprus. It was once a stronghold of the powerful group known as the Crusaders. They used the castle as a main strategic point in the Middle Ages, not only as a place of defense, but also as a place of business. The area surrounding the castle was used for the production of sugar from the locally grown sugarcane. But it wasn't actually built by the Crusaders or even for the Crusaders. Colossi Castle was constructed in the year 1210 by the Frankish military. By Frankish, I mean the old kingdom of Francia, which would turn into France. After construction was complete, the castle was handed over immediately at the behest of King Hugh I of Cyprus to the Knights of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem. Now, these are not the same knights you're thinking of. They were more commonly called the Knights Hospitallers, and they were an early Catholic military order with their headquarters in Jerusalem until the year 1291. They were different from the Knights Templar in that they were more of a religious order that supported the hospital. Their group formed officially after the conquest of Jerusalem in 1099 and still exists to this very day. The Knights Hospitallers played a much larger role in history than the Knights Templar, as they even colonized a small part of America in the 17th century, four islands in the Caribbean. As for Colossae Castle, it wasn't occupied by the Knights Templar we all know so well until 1306, just a few years before their order was torn apart. By 1313, the castle was back in the hands of the Hospitallers. Thanks for watching! Which of these mighty fortresses do you think was the most impressive? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. See you soon! Bye!